Hello everyone, hola a todos, welcome back to my channel. My name is Sekhmet Devine, aka The Brown Yogi. So, now that we understand what shadow work is, how do we do it?
Hey beautiful beings, if you haven't already checked out part one, which is the history of shadow work and what it is, go ahead and click the link. If you already understand what shadow work is, keep on watching.
Well, in my experience, I have five stages that are in a cycle. And I say they're in a cycle very specifically because in my experience, the cycle repeats over and over again. Because there's not just one or two things in my life that trigger me or bring out a shadow self. In fact, there's a lot. And so it's a cycle, right? I move through one trigger, I analyze it, I move through it, and then it's another, and it's another, and it's another. Now, you might find in your experience, you do a huge ego death, and then that's it. That's really awesome too. But in my experience, it's been a large unraveling over these past 2 years, and it will continue, right? Because it's been 20 years of me learning seeds of self-hate, self-doubt, and fear. It's gonna take time to undo that. So the five steps are as following. One, questioning. Two, acknowledgement. Three, acceptance, the it is. Four, meditation. And five, integration. Questioning. Where does this behavior come from? Why do I feel upset when I see that? Why do I get angry? Why did I lash out? Why do I feel hurt by this? Why am I choosing to ignore my true feelings?
This is such a huge step because many of us willfully ignore what's right in front of us, but we can't just ignore it. It's not going to make our problems or demons go away. We must face them head on.
Acknowledgement. It is what it is. It's there. It doesn't have to own me. I don't have to give it my power, but it's there.
Guilt and shame over what we did in the past doesn't have to control us. It's okay you did stuff you weren't proud of. We all have stuff that we weren't proud of. It doesn't mean you can't reinvent yourself, and it certainly doesn't mean that you don't deserve to create a life that you love. Accepting the past, accepting that perhaps this moment isn't exactly how we want it to be, gives us some room to relax and breathe. It's saying, yeah, those things are happening or did happen, but I can choose to still find joy in this moment.
Acceptance. It is what it is. It is what it is, y'all. The past is what it was, but this moment I have is an opportunity. The angel of death takes that past moment right from me. So I don't have to worry about the past because it's gone. But I have this moment to choose better. Meditation. Meditation looks different for everyone. It's not just sitting crisscross applesauce in silence, blocking off all of your senses. It could be painting, right? Just like Jung did with his patients, he had them do creative expression. It could be dancing, it could be making music, it could be cleaning your house, it could be going on a walk. There's lots of different things that you can do to meditate, but I do recommend that you at least have some moments to yourself every day in silence and stillness. Integration. How can I do better? How can I accept that that's who I was in the past? And these habits that I realize that no longer serve me, I don't need to confront them with anger or with hatred, but just acceptance for what it is, a habit, a mechanism, a defense mechanism that I used in the past to help me that no longer works now. I really, really encourage you guys to have the utmost compassion and respect for yourself because you deserve it. It's okay that you made mistakes in the past. We all did. Everyone has things that they need to unlearn. But what matters is what you're gonna do to be a better person than who you were yesterday. Can you react less? Can you cut off the BS? Can you go after the dreams that you've been really, really wanting to and your soul has been asking you to, but you felt too afraid to do? Can you be of service to the collective? Can you help Mother Nature? Can you be more compassionate and empathetic? Get ready to cry. And if you don't want to cry, then there you go. There's the first thing you need to uncover in your shadow work journey. Why don't you want to cry? But for real, y'all, be patient with yourself. It took time for you to build those habits that are not truly serving you. Recognize it for what it is. something you thought that was going to make your experience better, because we're all just trying to do our best. So it's okay that those things that we did back then no longer work and we want to do better. In fact, that's an awesome sign of growing and maturing, but it's going to take time to replace those habits with seeds of love. And as you do all of this, a very, very important thing I want to pass on to y'all is that when you are going through your shadow work, it is likely that you will build up a lot of negative energy as you are really confronting things that for many of us, we did not want to and purposefully forgot, purposefully pushed back in our heads so that we wouldn't confront it. And as a result, when you're confronting all of those hurts, you may notice that you're building up a lot of anxious energy, a lot of just sadness. So it is very, very important that you do not let that anxious energy, that angry energy, that hateful energy, whatever the feelings might be, it's really important that you don't just let that sit in your body.
And remember, sometimes that energy doesn't even come from you. Sometimes it's generational trauma that is living inside of you and that is asking to be released. Whatever the case may be, don't let that energy sit inside of you.
As my awesome yoga teacher says, move that shit through. Move that energy through. Do yoga. Walk. Run. Spend time outside. Do things that are gonna take that energy out of your body. Can you create something with that energy? Can you do something with all that energy? Because it's likely that energy will arise, whether it's a happy energy or a sad energy or a hurt energy. We can't keep that energy bottled up inside. It needs to go somewhere. And a basic lesson in energy, it doesn't die, it is merely transformed. So it is up to us to take that energy and transform it into something useful. Don't let it sit in you, okay? You deserve release. You deserve that weight lifted off of you. Me and you, we deserve a life that's not filled with suffering. We deserve a life that is peaceful and joyful, uplifting and fulfilling. So let's create that for ourselves, yeah? Yeah.